Well, hello, and welcome to the International Space Station in 1 in 100 scale, made from paper and a little bit of brass in certain areas. This is a model made from three different sources, most notably Alfonso Marino at AXM Space Paper Models. Outstanding model designs from Alfonso to represent the real and genuine condition of the space station. And we're looking at the Kibo module here, recently rebuilt Kibo module. The original one was a little small. And you can see the robot arm on Kibo, and the exposed facility here containing different experiments. We pan across the front of the station here. Normally the space shuttle would dock to this port here. This is Node 2, and above Node 2 is the Japanese HTV resupply vehicle, which contains pressurized and unpressurized parts, and pallets of experiments, which you can't see on this side. This is the Columbus Laboratory, the European Space Agency Laboratory. And as we pan around, the largest structure on the space station is the central truss, which spans about 100 meters from end to end. We're missing the solar panels from the truss at this stage. But in this end, on the starboard side, we can clearly see the mobile base station and the Canadian remote manipulator system, the gigantic robot arm, which travels up and down the truss on the fastest and slowest railway in the world. Down here on the stand, you can see the port 3 truss that goes on the opposite end of the truss here. Looking down here, we can see in the center of the picture the US laboratory with the truss connected to it. And the exposed pallet connected to the airlock in the middle here. As we traverse along the truss, you can see that the truss is actually hollow inside and is an open beam. And behind the truss, you can see the radiator panels here, which rotate nicely. And they're all made from paper. They're sitting in little brass tubes, which allow them to rotate. These are for cooling the station. Pump ammonia through them to keep the station cool. If we slide around to the back of the station, we can see the Russian section. We'll just tilt those out of the way. And we can see Unity Node here in the center of the screen. This was the first US part to be launched back in 99, I think, or something like that. Above this, the Z1 truss containing the gyroscopes you can see in the back there, which keeps the station oriented. And the back of the S0 truss, and if we look down right in there, we can see what's known as the rat's nest, for obvious reasons. Panning back and away now, you can see the unpressurized cargo carrier for the HTV. And now we move on to the Russian part of the station. This is Zarya. It's missing its folded panels. This is the first Russian component. Behind this, we have Zvezda, which is one of the main parts of the station. And connected to Zvezda, we have the Pier's docking module, and up above, a Progress resupply vehicle from Russia. And at the very back of the station, we have the European ATV, the automated transfer vehicle, and this, I can't remember where this model came from, somewhere on the net. Down below you can see Poisk ready to be fitted with this magnetic docking system. And we also have here the T3 truss, which I've also just completed. And so that's what I've been busy working on and off over the last 6 years, I think, maybe even 7 years, with some hiatus in the middle there. Well, I hope you enjoyed the tour of the International Space Station. Come back soon.